This is the most flexible budget price monitor for the Mac Mini or Mac Studio with the required features needed for video editing. 99% sRGB color accuracy. That's factory certified. It's got a perfect PPI for macOS, powered USC port, and an IPS panel. And what more do you want for $339? I'll tell you all about this magic monitor in this review. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell to be advised of more reviews as they're published about Final Cut Pro and the Mac OS. This monitor doesn't come from a brand you'd normally associate with high-end design monitors. But to be fair, this is not the absolute best video editing monitor for the Mac. And that's likely to be the 5K Mac Studio monitor or the uber-expensive Apple XDR display. It's the value proposition about this monitor that I'm talking about. It's not a $5,000 monitor. The Lenovo P27H-10 is just $339. I wouldn't suggest this is the main monitor for a professional setup. It's, however, absolutely suitable for a startup or as an extended second monitor for non-critical professional work. Just consider what the P27H offers for its $300 price tag. It's got 99% sRGB color accuracy, and that's complete with a printed factory certificate and that IPS panel for blacker blacks. It's got the perfect PPI for the default macOS resolution. It connects with USB-C, which is also powered to charge your laptop. Let me tell you more, but first, this is not a sponsored review, nor was a monitor supplied by the manufacturer for the review. I own this monitor, and it's my extended monitor on a Mac Studio computer, with the main monitor being an Apple Studio display. I'm going to cover the Mac's specific features of the P27H first. In a previous review, I discussed the perfect setup for macOS, the truth about Mac monitors. Check the eye above if you want to look at that review. And the essence in the truth review is that there are two major considerations when picking a monitor for video editing on the Mac. And the first is color accuracy. And as I've already told you, this one is 99% sRGB with a factory certification. The second requirement is suitability for the Mac OS, which has got a default resolution best suited for 109 ppi or 218 ppi for 5K. The P27H fits perfectly here. It's got a PPI of 108.79, just about bang on. I'll show you where to set that resolution in the Mac system display settings. Here you can set it as a mirrored or an extended display, or even the main display if that's how you want to set it up. You can arrange where you want the extended monitor to appear in relationship to the main monitor, including the advanced settings if you want to tweak. The color profile is recognized by the Mac, so you don't need to do anything here, it just works. There is an issue that I found with 4K monitors, and that's even though they've got that high pixel resolution of 3840 by 2160. They still leave a little bit of a shadow or a blur at the edge of the letters in words on a printed document on the display. Even though the P27H is 2K, that's 2560 by 1440, that's not as high a resolution as 4K, the shadow doesn't appear to be anywhere near as prominent. So up to now, we've been talking about the monitor fitting the major requirements needed for video editing in the Mac OS. What about those less significant details, or as I'd call them, the day-to-day dynamics? They're not all good, but there are some surprising features that you wouldn't expect, some I wish were on Apple's Studio monitor. The P27H has a fully adjustable stand that's up and down and tilt, and the raising and the lowering of the stand is really smooth and easy. If you wanted to have a height adjustable stand on the Apple Studio display, that's an extra $600. The P27H also pivots 360 degrees. That's into portrait mode. How about a web page in portrait mode on a 27-inch monitor? If that floats your boat. And just a note here, the portrait mode is set on the Mac in the display section of the system preferences that you just looked at before. The Mac immediately finds the monitor as soon as you attach it with the USB-C cable. In fact, you don't actively need to do anything, just drag a window to the new monitor, and you've got 27 inches of high resolution display. The ease of use is quite spectacular. And a technical note to be aware of, if you're adding it as an extended monitor to an Apple Studio display or any other monitor, the main monitor will need to be connected by HDMI, and then the extended monitor with a USB-C to USB-C cable. Ports galore. Once you've attached the monitor by USB-C, you've then got a further four USB-A ports for all those legacy devices. And if you've got the use for it, the P27H also has a standard VESA mount mounting option. So what about those handicaps? The main controls need some getting used to. The menu's selected and you see the options on the screen just above. The left and right arrows move to the different settings and then you press OK to start adjusting that setting. Just like the brightness here. So the trick is to remember to press OK after each selection. At the end of the day though, once they're set, you don't need to play with them anymore, hopefully. While in the menu section, you'll also notice that any tweaks that you do make seem to have little effect. In fact, I wondered in some cases whether in fact anything changed under the contrast and brightness settings. The stand's rather bulky, but I guess it just needs to be that way to retain the balance of the portrait mode. However, the big drawback is the access to the ports. They're really hard to see unless you pivot the monitor, which is something you don't want to be doing on a regular basis. And don't even think about the speaker. So what's the P27H best for? For me, the monitor is the ideal extended monitor for non-critical work, like the web pages and lists. And that means I don't have them cluttering up my main monitor that's just used for Final Cut Pro. With that said, the monitor's also ideal for the hobbyist video editor, as the colour accuracy is good and the PPI is perfect for the Mac OS, so there's no load on the Mac's processor. If you're just starting out in video editing and you need a low-cost monitor, this is the perfect setup for the Mac along with Final Cut Pro. Yes, if you're looking for a feature-filled USB-C Mac monitor that can charge your laptop. No, if you're into gaming and you need to regularly add devices to the USB ports. To be notified of further reviews on other monitors, please like and subscribe and be sure to press the bell. Thanks for watching.